And now, What's My Line? Brought to you by Stop at Spray Deodorant. Poop, there goes perspiration. Poop deodorant body powder, the body powder you spray. The Nest shampoo, the new flowing cream shampoo. All in the first truly functional cosmetic containers, far easier to use. All created by Dr. Jules Montagnier, the famous cosmetic chemist. Time now to enjoy What's My Line?
Now let's meet our What's My Line panel of well-known personalities whose lines you already know. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in the New York Journal American and papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
On my left, the very contented author of a very funny new book called Good for a Laugh, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
Is a very contented collector of lots of royalties on thousands of replicas of that little diamond heart she always wears. Miss Arlene Francis.
And thank you for the business.
Yeah.
And on my left, one of my favorite wags who never lags with the gags, Hal Block.
Thanks to one of my favorite romances, Arlene Francis.
Thank you.
And on my left, one of my favorite news commentators, a man who's going to do a show for all the losing football teams called Where's My Line, Mr. John Daly.
Thank you, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to What's My Line, presented by Stop It. Once again tonight, we've got a few people who have been nice enough to be our guests. They've come from all about these United States with varied, we hope, unexpected occupations, all of them here to baffle the panel to the happy end that they'll carry home some prizes. We'll also have a famous guest challenger before the panel a bit later in the program, but now to start things rolling, it's time for the experts to meet our first challenger whose job they've got to spot. So will you sign in, please, ma'am? Tony Muir, is that right? Would you tell us where you're from?
I'm from Greensboro, North Carolina.
And is it Miss or Mrs.?
Miss.
Miss?
Miss? We're in business.
Take a nice wide loop there, and then take a walk down in front of the panel for me, will you?
And then loop right back.
Greensboro, North Carolina? I was there 2 weeks ago.
That's a beautiful outfit. Is that a North Carolina outfit, or have you been shopping on Fifth Avenue?
Well, thank you, Mr. Kilgallen. It's from Monteldon.
North Carolina.
Well,
certainly
she.
That's lovely. I've often wondered about that.
Any questions?
You come on over here, Miss Muir, please, and sit down next to me. That heart of Arlene's catches a lot of attention. As a matter of fact, she catches a lot of hearts, let's face it. Well, now let's get on with what we're up to here. On the basis of your handwriting and this ride that you took, or walk you took down in front of the panel, at this point, we'll always give them one free guess as to what your line may be. We'll begin the free guesses with Miss Kilgallen.
I think she writes society.
Writes society. Mr. Cerf.
The biggest girls' college in the country is Greensboro, and I think Miss Muir teaches there.
Miss Francis.
Oh, lucky students. I don't know that I've ever seen a lady one. Perhaps you're a wine tester. This is the season for it.
A wine tester. Mr. Block.
Well, I think she's a bill collector. And if she is, just call me Bill.
I'm afraid nobody has it right. We let our viewers at home have a further look at Miss Muir, and at the same time, we'll tell them what her line is. The panel's got it big. All right, now, Miss Muir, what happens from this point on is every time you can give them a no answer, cost the panel $5, we'll keep a record up here. 10 no's, you've won the game. No problems, all right? Last bit of help for the panel, Miss Muir, is salaried. With that, we'll begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Do you perform a service, Miss Muir?
Yes.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
No.
That's one down. Nice.
Yes,
job.
It is, John.
Mr. Sir.
That destroys a lot of ideas I had about Miss Muir.
I don't know.
Doesn't destroy any of mine.
It doesn't destroy your initial one,
Miss Muir, do you have some kind of a government job?
Some kind of a what?
Government job. Work for some kind of government
agency.
Work
for some kind of a government agency. You mean the federal government agency?
I didn't say that.
Well, I mean, would you... Actually, what we're trying to do is to get you when you say agency...
Is it an agency of either federal, state, or local government?
Oh, yes, isn't it?
It is. Well, just to get down, take a wild guess, is it correct that it is not a federal agency?
Yes, it is correct that it is not a federal agency.
Is it by any chance a local agency pertinent to Greensboro and vicinity?
Yes.
Has it got anything to do with instruction of any kind?
No.
Not actually, that would be incidental. I think we'll give you a no there, and that would be 2 down and 8 to go, Miss Francis.
Do you have to have any particular training in your job?
Yes.
Do you have to have a formal education for your job?
A formal education, by which we mean a college degree. I don't think that would be necessary. There'd be 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Block.
Has it been determined whether she has anything to do with a product?
Has it been determined whether she has anything to do with a product? No, it has not been determined.
Well, does she have?
Does she have anything to do with a product? That'll make it 4 down and 6 to go. All right, Miss Kilgallen.
Do you deal with human beings in your work?
Yes.
Do you deal with both men and women?
Yes.
You work indoors ever?
Sometimes.
Is it also possible for you to do some of your work out of doors?
Yes.
Are people glad to see you when you perform your services?
Are people glad to see her when she performs her services?
Yes.
I think it's only fair to say that there are usually some about who are glad to see her, and then it's barely possible there might be some about who are not glad to see her. Would you accept that as well?
But yes. I would imagine that the service she performs is one for which the community at large is grateful.
Hmm. Yes.
Are you connected with any branch of law enforcement?
Law enforcement, did you say?
Yes.
Yes.
Do you do any type of police work?
Yes.
Don't tell me you're a lady policeman.
Yes, Mr. Brown. How easy is it to break a law out there? I may leave.
I would say that if you just went to Greensboro, they would probably consider that was breaking the law. So go ahead. Meanwhile, Miss Muir is a policewoman from Greensboro, and we're very happy that you came all the way up here to see us. You've done fairly well with the prizes, but more important, we hope you enjoyed your visit.
I have.
It was nice to have you with us. Now, let's see what you can do with another challenger. Will you sign in, please, sir? Saul Strome, is that right? Strome? Nice firm hand you have.
Thank you, sir.
Would you mind telling us where you come from?
The Bronx.
The Bronx. Well, if it's a part of New York, none of these people are strangers to you, but you're still something of a stranger to them, and they want to know you a bit better. So would you walk down in front of the panel for me, please?
May I feel that firm hand clasp?
How firm is it? I'll take a chance.
All right, Mr. Strone, right over here, if you will, and sit down next to me, and on the basis of your short tour in front of the panel, your handwriting, that fine blue suit you have on, that cheerful, smiling face, we give them one free guess as to what your line may be, and we begin the free guesses, as usual, with Miss Kilgallen.
I think he's a diamond cutter.
A diamond cutter. Mr. Cerf.
I'm going to stick to teacher. I'll get right on that yet.
Miss Francis.
I think he makes Halloween masks.
Mr. Block.
I think he makes collapsible platforms for political candidates.
Well, I'm afraid nobody has it right. We'll let the viewers have another look at Mr. Strone, and at the same time, we'll tell them what his line is. Mr. Strone, you know the rules of the game. Every no answer that you can dig out of that panel over there is going to cost them $5. We'll keep the record of all this right up here. 10 knows you've won the game, and we always give them one last bit of help, which I'm sure you won't mind. Mr. Strone is self-employed. With that, we'll begin the general questioning with Mr. Block.
Do you deal in services, Mr. Strone?
Yes.
Do people come to you?
Yes.
Would I ever come to you?
I don't think it's possible, really.
Well, might. I say, might I ever come to you?
No.
Well, we got to have a further conference. If only somebody else in the panel had asked this question.
Can I rephrase it?
No, you don't have to rephrase it. We will say that probably the only way you'd achieve the culmination of Mr. Strone's dream...
You know, you've lost me already?
Yeah, I've lost it, too. I think it's barely possible you might go to Mr. Strone, yeah.
Well, could you do anything for me?
I doubt that. Mr. Strone is the supreme optimist. He says he thinks he could do something for you.
Might be another jailer. Well, what you do, your service, are they advisory in any capacity or instructive?
Yes.
Well, when people come to you, are they ever happier on account of what you do for them?
Yes.
They are. Oh, yes, they are.
Well, then you're sort of an unusual occupation.
I would say this, that in terms of the numbers who might be operating in this field, it would be unusual. Wouldn't you say that? Yes.
Well, if I used your services, would I then be able to do something that I hadn't done before? Do this in front of an audience.
Actually, Mr. Block, you've opened a door that is very wide.
Want to close it?
If you were to avail yourself of Mr. Strone's services, you would so change your estate that there would be a good deal of things that you might do that you... And some of them you would do and some of you wouldn't. So you go on.
Well, has this ever been done on television?
Yes, actually, I can attest that the culmination of Mr. Strone's best efforts have been on television.
Well, does this have anything to do with wrestling?
No, nothing to do with wrestling. One down and nine to go, Miss Kilgallen.
What did I do?
Does your service apply to both men and women?
Yes.
Or would it ever apply to them at the same time?
Yes.
Do you do something for them that benefits them both?
Yes.
Mutually? And do they come to you to have this service performed?
Yes.
Does it have anything to do with changing their station in life?
Like a subway conductor.
I don't mean their career. I don't mean their job. I mean their estate.
Their estate or status. Well, I would say that... it is possible that as a ramification, if not necessarily a first result of Mr. Strone's services, there might be a change in estate, station, or condition, shall we say.
Would it ever have anything to do with romance?
Romance, should you say?
Mm-hmm.
I guess, yeah, it has something to do with romance.
And if Mr. Strone's operation were successful, and I use that word very loosely, would something happen legally ever?
We hope so, yes.
And would he ever be involved with arranging this marriage?
We're having a small conference.
Anybody want to dance?
Gets by Stonewall.
We would say that, in a very general sense, Mr. Strone is willing to admit that he might have something to do with the arrangement.
Well, does he bring people together who are interested in finding a life partner?
Yes.
But what is the word for that? Is
Mary
that
Mary Coulter?
A shot.
Well, actually, I think...
That's what it was.
Maker or a marriage broker or a...
If you can get hold of that last jailer, you've got some work to do here.
And just to clear one thing, Mr. Bach, you made the point as to whether or not what Mr. Stone did would be done on television. There is a program, I think, devoted entirely to marriages.
Bride
on
and
television.
Groom.
Bride and groom,
really?
Which is why I said...
You can do that on television?
Yeah, on television. Well, now, Mr. Stone, you didn't do too well with the prizes, but we certainly hope you enjoyed your visit because it was nice to have you with
us.
Very nice to see you. And now, in just one moment, ladies and gentlemen, we'll introduce our mystery. And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity. And my friends on the panel would certainly recognize our guest on site, so we've provided them with blindfolds. Are they all in place, panel?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now, sir.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? Panel, as you know, in the case of our mystery celebrity, we dispense with all the usual preliminaries, get right down to the general questioning, which we will begin with Miss Arlene Francis.
Are you an entertainer?
Uh-huh.
That kind. Are you male?
Uh-huh.
Have you appeared as a performer in pictures?
No.
1 out of 9 to go, Mr. Block.
Have you ever been on television before this?
Uh-huh.
This kid honks the answer. Do you by any chance ever sing?
Oh.
2 out of 8 to go, Miss Kilgallen.
When you say you're a performer, are you a performer in some branch of show business rather than sports?
Uh-huh.
Do you do any form of acting?
You mean any form of acting?
Yes, any form at all.
I guess we'd have to admit you do any form of acting.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Have you ever appeared on the stage?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh.
Did you ever appear on the stage in New York City?
By which you mean the whole general area of...
That's right.
Yes. Uh-huh. You got me doing it, too.
Uh-huh.
When you appeared on the stage, were you in a presentation house rather than, let us say, a legitimate theater?
Uh-huh.
In other words, you would play at a place like the Roxy or the Paramount or the Strand?
Uh-huh.
Are you ever funny?
Uh-huh.
I'll answer that one. He's very funny.
He is tonight.
Are you then primarily a comedian?
Uh-huh.
Do you work with any stooge or stooges or other persons?
Me? No, not... They don't mean tonight. They mean ordinarily.
No.
No, that's 3 down and 7 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Am I to take it then you are essentially a monologist?
I beg your pardon, Mr.
When you do your comedy turn, you are essentially appearing in one, that is, doing it by yourself.
Uh-huh.
Have you ever acted as a master of ceremonies for any radio or television program?
Mm-hmm.
Are you currently performing in this capacity for a show that appears once a week?
Mm-hmm.
Has anybody ever angered you by telling you that you were directly in the Will Rogers tradition?
Why should he be angry?
Well, I think we're putting an unnecessary burden on you, Mr. Cerf. I think perhaps it might have been said.
Well, would you say that you were came from somewhere in the Indiana territory?
Uh-huh.
I'm afraid this is Herb Schreiner.
That's who it is. Herb, you are in
River Court.
I'm afraid we are.
What's the name of the show? What's My Schreiner?
Yeah, What's My Schreiner? No. Two for the money, I believe. But actually, the thing that I'm surprised at, the minute he said, oh, I knew what it was, I can't get his
Well, you saw him.
Well, I mean, I think that helped a little bit, but...
I thought they'd think I was Lyman Abner.
Oh?
I just wrote a piece about Herb for this week's magazine, so if I didn't recognize him, I'd be an awful dummy.
Well, you are not a dummy.
I was a little afraid of him, you know.
You had it right.
We thought you were adorable.
How's the new show going, Two for the Money?
It's going fine, and, of course, it's a another network, I guess, isn't it?
I understand there are others.
It's on Tuesday night, of course, and it's we're also sponsored by another cigarette.
Oh, another cigarette.
Yes.
There are others. Stop it.
Have a bottle of Stop It.
Have you ever smoked Stop It?
It's sponsored by Old Gold, if you wouldn't mind my mentioning it.
Not a bit.
It's run by Goodson and Todman, isn't it?
It is, come to think of it. And it's another show where we interview people, if you wouldn't mind my mentioning that.
Not at all.
Call Two for the Money, in fact.
I tell you what, you do my Sunday night, and I'll do yours on Tuesday, because I got a date for next Sunday. Maybe we can do something
All right.
like that.
That's good. Well, I had a date for tonight, so I showed up.
Well, Herb, it's wonderful of you to come and give us your Sunday night, because I know you're a busy man during the week, and thanks a lot for coming to see us.
Thank you very much. Night.
Will you go and say good night to the family? Time is running out. Let's see what you can do with another challenger. Would you please come in and sign in, ma'am? Elizabeth? Elizabeth Gill Fillon. Is that right? All right. That's right. How are you? Would you tell us, first of all, where you live?
I live in New York City, that is, Tudor City, but I was born in Minnesota. My father was a missionary to the Indians, and I went barefoot until I was 19.
Good heavenly days. Would this be a rude question? How old are you now, then?
Well, I'm nearly 73 now.
What?
Good.
Child.
My heavenly days, you look young enough to be my daughter. Would you then please take a romp down there in front of the panel for me, please?
Honey, you may be 73, but you got the spirit of 76.
Block,
All right, Miss Gilfillan, would you come over here now, please, and sit down next to me?
Well, I washed my hands because I thought,
well, then I'm going to look after Well, they're very nice, and that's a very pretty shade of nail polish.
All right, Miss Gilfillan, would you come over here and sit down now, because we have only about 3 minutes to go, panel. So that on the basis of the quick look that you have had at our guest, we now go back to our regular format, which is the free guest, and we begin the free guest with Miss Kilgallen.
I think she teaches dancing.
Mr. Cerf.
I think she's a needlework expert.
Miss Francis.
I think she's a wardrobe mistress.
Mr. Block.
I think she's cute.
Well, I think she's cute, too, but that's not enough of an answer, so we'll let our viewers at home have a further look at Miss Kilfillan, and at the same time, we'll tell them what her line is. Well, panel, you got a dig. Miss Kilfillan, every time that you give a no answer, costs them $5. We keep the record up here. 10 no's, you've won the game. Miss Kilfillan is self-employed. With that, we'll begin the general questioning with Bennett Cerf, and we have about 2 minutes and 15 seconds to get it.
Miss Kilfillan, do you perform services of any kind?
Yes.
Do you go to people's houses to perform the service? Ever?
Not as a rule.
Do you sometimes go?
But I sometimes
go?
Do.
When you get there, would you say that you did some kind of artistic or aesthetic work of any kind?
Artistic or aesthetic? I don't think we would call that artistic.
No.
That's 1 down and 9 to go, Miss Trent.
Do you have anything to do in any way with children?
No. Decidedly not. No.
2 down and 8 to go, Mr. Block.
You deal mostly with grown-ups, then?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Both men and women?
Yes.
Mr. Block, ask her if she can use your service, or you can use her service.
Well, if it'll make you happy, would I be the kind of a person that would use your services?
No, you wouldn't need it.
Miss Sylvie, he would! He'd need it!
At last, I've been kissed by a man.
All right, Mr. Block. I will not ruin you out because I think you'd need her services. So you go on with the questioning, Mr. Block.
I'm overwhelmed from kissing her. I'll pass to Dorothy.
All right, Miss Kilgallen.
At other times, do people come to you to have the service performed?
Yes, sometimes.
Do you come into physical contact with them?
What was that?
Do you come into physical contact with these people?
Well, only very occasionally.
I see. Well, is your work mostly mental?
Oh, no, not at all. No.
No, that's 3-7 to go, Mr. Cerf.
Miss Gilfillan, would your work involve any kind of repairing or fixing?
Yes, it does,
but our time is running out, and I'll tell you what kind of repairing. Miss Gilfillan is a facelifter. She teaches facial exercises that would tighten up the muscles and move down the thing.
Well, bless you, Miss Gilfillan.
And I know I'm not a Venus, especially on television, but give me time. I'm still improving. Maybe by the time I'm 80, I'll look like something.
You can't miss. And thanks very much for being out here for What's My Line. We have a full time. And now, in just a moment, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to give you a preview look at one of our guests whose line our panel is going to be asked to try and identify on next week's program. But first, here is some excellent advice. Next week at the same time, our panel of experts will be asked, what's my line by this young lady? Would you know what her occupation is? Could you spot her line? Well, for the answers to these and a good many other questions, be sure to be back with us again next Sunday night at 10:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, when once again, StopEt invites you to play What's My Line. For other localities, check your local listings to find out where we are and at what time. And until then, this is John Daly saying good night, Dorothy.
Good night, Bennett.
Good night, Arlene.
Good night, Al.
Good night, John.
And good night, ladies and gentlemen, and thanks for being with us on What's My Line.
This has been a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. In association with the CBS...
Hey, learn how to tell the truth with Bud Collier next. Then get ready to test your word power with Alan Ludden and Password. Only on Game Show Network.